I'm so defeated even at the idea of doing this again. Right after we were done filming, somebody else walked into my house. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to name any names. And they grabbed my camera and they formatted the memory card. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay.
To clarify, everything Bob's getting today, Bob, I always make this so confusing. You do it.
You, for Christ's sake.
So I'm buying things for Wood. Wood's buying things for me. In this video that I'm making, I'm going to be opening the stuff Wood bought for me at the end. So we're doing a little swap. Mm. If you want to see the stuff that I bought for Wood, you got to watch his video.
Good job.
We did 500 last time.
We're doing 1,000.
No.
Hey, take the Nintendo money.
Oh, yeah, we have a business now.
Yeah.
We have a business
we have
account.
A budget and stuff. This is advertising for our podcast.
My
guys,
God.
We have a podcast together. It's called
podcast.
The Nintendo Podcast. We do it every week.
Let's
no,
do
actually,
$2,000.
There's 50. No, we need some rules. Listen, my channel is a little different than your channel.
Yes.
I need something that would look good in the thumbnail. I need something that's like tech-related I can mess around with, okay?
Then can I request
down.
Something?
Sure.
The same thing for me?
No,
that
it better
is
be,
an anime
it better
wife
be
boobies. No!
They like that.
Oh, so we have oh, I'm sorry. I was watching this video in my VITURE XR glasses. These things are awesome, and they're also sponsoring this video. But let me tell you why they're so cool. I play games in these glasses. Right now, I have a 120-inch screen floating in the middle of my game room playing Red Dead Redemption on Nintendo Switch. I can also stream my PlayStation, my Steam account, anything that is streamable to the glasses. In fact, there's a PlayStation and Xbox streaming app that's usually like $5, but they partnered with VITURE and they come free in the glasses. All that happens with the magic of the neckband. The cord has a magnetic clip that just snaps straight onto the glasses, and then I can plug this straight into my Steam Deck and it'll throw to the glasses, and just like that, I'm playing Spider-Man right in front of my face. So VITURE has this dock that you can snap on the back, but it has a advantages. Once you plug it into your Switch, you'll not only keep your Switch charged because it works as a power bank, there are two slots for eye holes. So you can have two glasses plugged into the one Switch console. There's even this neat feature where if I tap this button, it'll dim the edge around the glasses to make it easier to see the screen. I am obsessed with these glasses. I can't wait to take them on a plane when I go to Japan. If you want to grab a pair or check them out, I'll leave a link down below. Thank you, VITURE, for sponsoring this video. The future is actually getting pretty cool.
So we have rules on what to buy. We have a limit of $1,000.
Yeah, that's a lot. That's kind of a lot.
All right, bye.
Okay,
see you. Bye. Get out of here. Bye.
Buy me cool stuff.
I'll do my best.
I didn't expect to have a budget of $1,000. He wants like a cool thing for the thumbnail, a cool big tech gadgety Nintendo Switch fake. Will that even come up? Is that even a thing that Amazon will sell? Emulator? He's. See, I'm instantly panicking. I do this every time. Most powerful handheld console. That's literally my whole budget. Cheapest handheld. Oh, well, this is better. Oh, yeah. He's gonna love this. It's so small.
It's the cheapest one I could find.
Anything else? Ooh, 5,000 games and it looks like a Switch? $80? Oh, we could even get one that looks like a Switch. Oh, yeah. He's gonna love it, chat. All right, we're gonna add that to cart. We're already crushing it. We still have $900 to spend and we've already satisfied his one criteria. I wanted to buy him this. I actually found this when I was making a weird Etsy video recently. I think he would actually get a kick out of this. Like, it's just like a nice gift. I'm gonna add this to the cart. He always messes with me and I know it and it's fine. It breaks my heart and it's fine. I try and mess with him back sometimes, but I'm feeling this time I'm just gonna overwhelm him with love and gifts. Maybe he'll see the other side and next time he'll be nice to me. Now I found this. Tell me this isn't sick, dude. Mario Bros. Diorama. You can get it 422 millimeters tall and assembled. Okay, here's another cool gift. So we play Valorant at night all the time. We always like try and debate on one more game or going to bed, and he can flip a coin and decide for it. See, isn't that sweet?
Oh, and this?
Dude, I did a lot of research for this. He always plays Chamber in Valorant, and I thought this would be really cute. It's his little teleporter totem. I have to get him this. Oh yeah, I was also kind of looking at, for him. And I thought he would really appreciate this Mario shirt, because he's a Mario fan. He's gotta be a medium, right? But he could be large because he's very tall. Are you there? Can you hear me?
Yes, hello.
I need your shirt size again. I forgot. forgot it.
It's a medium.
Okay, good. Good thing I checked. All right. He might have had a question to ask me, but that's fine. Yeah, he's going to love this.
He said he didn't want trinkets.
He can get a couple. He can get... He's going to love this. He loves Waluigi. How can I not? Safe for work? What's the safe for work one? It's a delicate balance of being nice, but also trying to... I gotta get small.
Small is cute.
Okay, see, now we're back to being nice. This is his favorite Switch game. I wanna grab him this. Oh, I was trying to find some memorabilia from the good Mario movie, and it's his favorite character in the Mario universe. King Koopa. It's his favorite. Add it to cart. Okay, so we're at 600. I still have $400 left. So it's a Funyun in the shape of Toad from Mario, which I don't actually think is true. I have looked at these photos in every direction I can, and I can't see Toad, but it's $100. I can't buy this, right? Oh, this is cool. Nintendo Game Boy Digital Watch. Come on now, that's pretty sick. Can you get like a watch emulator? Oh, now we're onto something. Wait, hold on. You can play games on it. Knowing Bob, he could probably put games on it somehow. Can I play games on this watch? Most any games for cell phone you can download from Google Play. The only issue is a smaller screen. You can download emulators on Google Play. And then he could have a thumbnail of playing games on his wristwatch. I think this is exactly what he wants. I'm putting it in the list. You still have $200 left. Okay. This is just an eight-minute warning. I repeat, an eight-minute warning.
Ah, you scared the piss out of me.
I'm sorry. Okay, bye. We've bought him some cool things. We've bought him some sexy things. We've bought him the thing that he wanted to have for the thumbnail. What about one-handed controller? What about this? Joystick, rechargeable Bluetooth, game controller. That's interesting. So theoretically, if he didn't want to use touch controls, he could use this thing, which would be pretty cool. Maybe I could do something with this picture. Custom Nintendo Switch shell. Create your own Joy-Cons. Is there a way that I could design Joy-Cons for him and have me on one and him on the other? This would take some time. I would need to go and design them, but I think that's a really good idea. The only thing is I need to design them, and there's no way I have time for that right now. And my timer just ran out. All right, that's it. Time's up. I'm done. I did it.
Okay.
I feel really good.
I feel great. $1,000 is a lot.
It went a long way.
I'm a little under budget, but I think with shipping and everything, it'll be fine.
Oh, with shipping, I might be over budget. So now everything's gonna arrive, and then you're gonna see me opening what Bob got me now, and vice versa on his channel. You wanna do a big, like, clap into the future, the echo through space and time?
Yeah, sure. Do a little, wait, hold on. Hold on a second. 3, 2, 1, beep.
This looks very nice. Is it me first?
Yes, it's you first, and I think you should explain what happened.
I'm so
why
defeated.
Why we're all here.
I'm so defeated even at the idea of doing this again. At this point, we bought everything maybe a year ago.
April, I looked.
It was a long time ago.
April, and now it's now.
And it was early July that we sat down and we opened it all at my house. And it was great. Oh, it was great. The kind of thing that you can't replicate. But we're gonna have to, because right after we were done filming, somebody else walked into my house. Mm-hmm. I'm not gonna name any names. And they grabbed my camera, and they formatted the memory card. Mm-hmm. And I wanna stress, I tried everything to get these files back. I even sent it off to a salvage data recovery plant. Mm-hmm. And they were like, there's nothing
we can
do.
They said this was so erased that it's gone. You can't get anything.
What we do have from it all is the camera shot.
We have this one.
And the audio. But the big wide shot is gone. So we're gonna have to redo it. I brought everything that you gave me back from my house, back to your house.
There's been some modifications, it seems.
Well, I put it, it's the biggest bag I had.
I'm so mad.
I don't remember these waifu shirts.
That's also mine. I wanted to protect this stuff. The story we told the first time where, like, I bought you smut, and normally you buy me smut, but this time you bought me all this nice stuff, and I was, like, in tears on camera. Anyway. What's in here?
I don't know. You wrapped these, so now you know what's in them, and I don't.
I know. Oh, look, it's a controller. So what he got me, a beat-em-ups N64 themed controller. And also, in this casing here, this beat-em-ups N64, which he was so nice, not only to do this once, but to do it twice.
I accidentally bought two of these.
You bought two of them.
You got me a beat-em-up 64!
I think there's a second one in here. Yeah, there's two. Like, I'm being beat 'em up 64, I guess.
It is really cool, so I'm glad that I have my own also. I think what I have to stress about these is that I got these custom made and then also I modified them. This one came with the black buttons, and I thought the black buttons looked better on the gold. I bought these blue buttons somewhere else, and I put the blue buttons there because it's beat 'em ups is your channel.
I know. And I'm glad you got me too, because when you were opening that one, you cut into it and there was a big gap.
Oh yeah. That, what a moment that we'll never see.
Also, oh, you cut this.
Oh no, wait, I opened that one.
Oh, thank God.
I did it. Oopsies.
Okay, so this is the Super 64 because I wanted to build you the ultimate N64. And they make HDMI mods so that you can plug this into a modern computer, because who has a CRT anymore? But the HDMI mod costs the exact same price as one of these. So instead of having to do anything, you just plug this little bitch in. Oh wait, we're on your channel. You just plug this little cool, awesome guy in, and it's HDMI.
You also got me Oracle of Seasons.
Oh wait, do I have that? I think I took one, because that's another thing. I accidentally bought two of them.
Yeah, you bought two of those as well.
Oh! Here's what's really cool about this. You remember Oracle of Ages? And the other game, Oracle of Ages.
Okay, so I bought two of those because I thought I was gonna try to put my own game on one of them. And I spent a few hours and realized I couldn't.
Also, we do have footage of us that wasn't deleted trying to set it up on the TV and playing it.
I mean, it looks good. What are you thinking? Italiano!
Hey, how you doing? Papino.
Wait, what's he doing to me? Oh! He like climbed inside of me.
Oh.
Speaking of climbing inside of me. What the heck? Hey, sweet girl. Thank you, Bob.
Oh, no problem.
We'll play this. We'll spend all night playing it. Slumber party, sleepover time.
I'm going home in like an hour.
So as you could imagine, if we were to recreate the moment, Bob, where you handed me this at the end of the video, after buying me all this nice stuff, the emotions, the love for each other, and there was a moment where you finally admitted that you think I'm becoming your closest friend, and you want me to be a best man at your wedding, and it was all this beautiful...
I have a brother.
And so do I. And now it's deleted. But I do really appreciate it.
Hold on. The whole arc of the story was that you were expecting more smut, and then there wasn't any.
Yeah.
Where's the smut?
Yeah. So, I looked for like an hour.
I want to say that every time we do one of these goddamn videos, I get you like really nice posters and stuff, and you leave them at the studio. The Pokemon ass and the other one is at the studio.
I promise you. I did not throw that away, mostly because I knew we were having to redo this at some point.
If this isn't tits and ass, I don't even know where to go from here with our friendship. Oh, thank God. Thank God.
I have some theories.
Okay.
There was like five other men in my basement. One was Bingle.
Okay.
I don't know where it is. I promise I didn't throw it away. I couldn't. I just
don't appreciate it. We can move on to the next one. I'm sure this video...
What's in that? It was my least favorite thing you gave me.
There was one thing you didn't open on camera.
We actually opened this on the podcast.
Oh, yeah.
So we have this is the only thing we had footage of.
That is really cool looking.
Yeah, it's awesome.
All right. I actually have no idea what could be in here. Maybe like a necklace or a medallion or something.
See, I know Zelda.
I know, but...
Ba-da-da-da!
Oh!
A silica packet.
It's a glass heart.
Mm-hmm.
You gave me a heart, Bob.
Because of how much I love you.
you were so over the top nice. Is this symbolic?
No.
Here's the thing, Bob. I loved everything you got me. You mostly got me this because it was expensive and you bought two. You blew the whole budget on buying two of these.
That might have been why it cost so much.
Sir Bobathon, the Gallant.
This was expensive.
Oh my God, what'd you get me, Excalibur?
He thought it was the Master Sword, which maybe it is, and I got my lore wrong, but
I don't understand what it is.
We tried Googling it, and there is no Black Master Sword that looks like this specifically. This is freaking awesome, but what it looks like is Zelda Master Sword meets Game of Thrones.
What you're saying is they did a bad job.
No.
Okay, so I'm gonna leave them a review. This cost $480.
Oh my God! I mean, it's very heavy, and I love it, and I wanna hang it on the wall. I can't stress enough that I do actually love it. Speaking of pointy weapons,
okay,
there is one more thing, and
you
I didn't
saying this one more
I didn't
thing.
I didn't need to box it because I've kept it in my pocket ever since you gave it to me.
Oh my God, you're one of those guys.
I saw it tonight. This was another one of the moments in the video because Bob has a knife that looks exactly like this. And every time I see him and he pulls this knife out and he like cuts something with it, I'm like, man, it's so cool that you always have a knife.
It's all awesome.
I told him that and then he remembered, and not only did he get me one, he got me a Zelda one.
You give
open
me.
That.
Oh, that's nice. nice. Oh, I love that. It's a Zelda knife.
So it was a moment that I treasure. Again, he was like, you're like a brother to me. And I think we should have a matching knife and necklace, but don't show anyone the necklace. But that's all deleted now. But you acknowledge it happened at least, which is what I appreciate about this moment. You also literally got me a heart.
Yeah, I didn't think about that.
You got
that. That is literally like, I love you. How cool would it have been though if you plugged in this N64
and it says, will you marry me? Well, that's everything. That was $1,000 spent on me. And I gotta tell you, the first time we did this was good. Like, comment, subscribe. Sorry if it was kind of a mess, but it is what it is.
Do we want to tell people that we're doing this because we have a podcast and that they should subscribe to that? Okay. You're right.